tagliata, messa fuori, c'è Pirlo, 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 ancora Pirlo, di tacco, tiro, gol!
Hello and welcome to the AC Milan Talk podcast. I'm your host, Sumit Paul, and as always, I'm joined by my good friend, Jason Brand. JB, how you doing?
I'm doing all right, mate. Not too bad.
Good man. Right, Jace, we built it up as Milan faced another big test against Roma, and unfortunately, we have to discuss another defeat tonight. We'll talk about the game, run through our player ratings, and what this latest failure means. But first, let's get your thoughts on the game. We spoke, obviously, prior to this one that, you know, we fell short against Lazio and Sampdoria. Sadly, even though we produced a much better performance, we were well in the game for the first 70 minutes. The reality is that we couldn't claim a win or even a point. I guess the overriding feeling is disappointment this weekend, Jace.
Yeah, it's got to be. You know, we talked, like you say, we talked it up before the game. Home game. It was a big test against another rival for the top spots, and like you say, in it, but just weren't good enough, to be honest. And there's nothing more you can say as opposed to we weren't unlucky. We just at the end didn't have that little bit of quality that Roma did, and it showed.
Certainly did. A lot of people again were saying that it was an improved performance. I personally felt there was a more fight and a bit more character in the team especially compared to the Sampdoria loss. I think there was massive improvements in that respect. But like I said, that quality wasn't there to take our chances, and then we paid for it. Roma took theirs, and here we are, another defeat. So let's go straight into player ratings. I want to start with Montella, actually. He's got a lot of criticism for waiting too long with his substitutions. We both slammed him last week in the Sampdoria game for waiting so long and then reacting to falling behind rather than, you know, being proactive. I feel like he's slipped into the same mistakes again. Calhanoglu was struggling in particular. And I feel as though if Montella had reacted quicker, brought on Bonaventura or just switched something, made the key changes, I think we could have had a very different result and we could have put Roma away. So, if as a rating out of 10 for the manager, I think I'm going to give him a 6 because I do feel as though he missed a window of opportunity to make something happen for us.
Yeah, I agree. I think, like you say, just slow. I think because it was 0-0, he didn't want to make that first step and kind of, you know, make that big move first, bring on someone else and really take the game to Roma. But, you know, ultimately cost us because when they scored two goals pretty quick succession, the game's over. It's too late for us to do anything, you know. But yeah, I definitely agree. I think that would have been one change I would have made way earlier. Probably would have brought on, looked to bring on Cutrone as well. You know, the energy that he showed midweek, and he's been shown all season, you know, to be fair. I reckon if he'd come on earlier, with the way we were playing at 0-0, I think his energy and his presence definitely would have given us more of a fighting chance.
Absolutely. Echo those points because I think they both came on with the last 10 minutes, I think it was in the end. And
yeah,
like you said, Cutrone, he offers that sort of energy and pressure up front, but can he really get up to speed with the game in 10 minutes? You know, he needs a little bit more than that, surely, to kind of have an influence on it, and especially with Bonaventura as well. I don't feel like he got up to the speed of the game, and you know, he didn't really have much of an impact. So if those guys had 20 odd minutes, 25 minutes, then I think, you know, they could have made a massive difference. But here we are, unfortunately, too late, and defeat it is. But let's crack on then, Jace. Donnarumma, I'm going to give him a 5. There was a risky pass out which Strootman almost made him pay for, which was a very nervy moment, which, you know, I wasn't particularly fond of. But he did produce a good save to deny Florenzi at a key point in the game, but I'm going to be potentially overcritical. I feel like he could have done better on the second goal. You know, I think he pushed that out, should have pushed it to safety rather than, you know, the rebound basically just falling into the path of Florenzi. So Donnarumma gets a 5 from me.
Yeah, I've got very similar points to you, but I gave him a 6 for that. I agree. I thought poor clearance could have definitely cost us. And I agree. I don't think you've been overly harsh at all. I think is that save was very poor. It's literally right back into the area where you don't want to put it, to be honest. But I felt, yeah, like you say, I maybe gave him a bit too much credit for the save he made. But yeah, I felt other than, you know, the mistake that he got away with and that poor save, I felt he was pretty solid and things like that. Good with the one-on-one with Dzeko. I thought he stood up well. But yeah, I think a six for me. But that's, you know, six or five, I guess, neither here nor there, is it?
No, that's fair enough. I can easily see why I'd give him a six. Masaccio gets a six from me. I think he dealt with El Shaarawy quite well. The only sort of critical aspect, again, I'm going to be a bit of a moaner tonight, I think, to pick out on the negatives, but I don't feel he's as composed on the ball as he usually is. I think he's quite rushed at the moment. I don't know whether that's just the lack of confidence seeping through the whole team or not, but, you know, at the start of the season, he was really composed. He was building play at the back. He was even, you know, bits of skill, just showboating as well. We've not seen that from him in the last couple of games, which is a bit of a concern. But defensively, which is obviously the most important thing, I think he did quite well. So I'm going to give him a six.
Yeah, I've gone with a five. I thought it was pretty poor with his possession on the ball, like you say. And I also thought it was a bit weak for Dzeko's goal. I thought he could have been maybe a bit stronger, made a bit more presence of himself, put him off, you know, to allow him to get the ball turned there and just hit that shot. And I think it deflected off him a little bit, didn't it? Which kind of made it pretty impossible for Donnarumma to, with the angles, I think, it kind of made it skip up a bit.
Yeah.
So I know that's unlucky, but I think he should have been, his presence, like when Dzeko picks the ball up, I think in that position, if he's stronger, Dzeko doesn't score, so I've given him a five there.
Fair enough. Bonucci, what are you giving him?
Giving him a six. I thought, again, the defence, we've talked about Bonucci, you know, he's not one for known for pace. But I felt he handled today much better than he had in the past few weeks. As well, you know, denied with good save from Alisson, which I was reading up on the stats. That was actually our first shot on target in like 181 minutes of league football, which is ridiculous to think that came in like the 60-odd minute of this game. But yeah, it was unlucky, I felt. But yeah, I thought it was an improved performance from his last league game. So I've given him a six.
Yep, I've given him a six as well. I definitely agree it was much improved. I kind of feel like it played into his hands a little bit because it was more of a physical aerial battle with Dzeko. And
yeah,
I think that kind of suits his strengths. And like I mentioned last week, I think if he comes up against a Mertens type striker, then we're in for a serious problem. But no, on this occasion, give him props, he did well. There were a couple of incidents where he kind of lingered on the ball, almost put us in a really bad situation. And again, I don't know, I personally feel like he could have done better in the build-up to the second goal. I feel like he got turned by Dzeko, who passed it inside and it kind of led to the goal. I think he could have done a little bit better, but that's just me being picky now, I think. But overall, I think he did well, so I'm going to give him a six, but still, question marks are certainly there. Romagnoli, I'm going to give him a five. I know it's probably, I don't know, I'll get your opinion in a minute, but I just feel he could have done a better job on Florenzi. I think he troubled him with his pace at times, and he's good on the ball, as always, but I just feel defensively there was still room for improvement. So not saying he was dramatically worse than the other two at the back, but I just feel there was a little bit more of a weakness there, so I'm going to give him a five.
Yeah, no, I've given him a five as well. I 100% agree with you. I felt, you know, Florenzi in particular was getting behind too easily. And as well, I've kind of felt, you know, with Dzeko's shot, I felt he could have come out a bit quicker. I don't know if he was worried about diving in, but I felt he kind of was just lost. And then once Dzeko's hit it, it's too late. You know, he can't do anything. So
yeah,
I've given him a five for that.
Fair enough. Fabio Barini, what are you giving him?
Barini, I've gone with a seven. I felt, you know, maybe over generous, but I felt he was doing a lot in the game in terms of his energy, and he wanted to try and push forward. He was open to receiving the ball and did make some intelligent runs and a lot of energy and hard work. I felt his end product wasn't there, but, you know, can't really fault his effort. I felt in this type of game, the way it was, you know, high energy, I felt we needed what he was bringing. And as I mentioned before, if we had him and Cutrone, both of that type of energy, and with Silva as well, what he was doing, I think if we had had the three of them, possibly we could have got a different result. But I thought Barini was one of the players trying to make things happen.
Yep, agreed. I've given him a 7, and I don't want to be accused of hating on Sunderland again. So
Yeah.
I'm going to give him a 7 this week. Completely agree with you. Energetic, defensively solid. Props to him as well, obviously, for showing his versatility to play in the right wing back position. And he was obviously more than willing to attack. And completely agree with your point as well. That only thing that was missing was the quality in the final phase, really. Whether it was decision making, whether it was the delivery into the box, not finding the teammate. That was the only thing missing from his performance. Otherwise, I'd have given him a higher mark. So 7 for Barini. Kessié, I've given a 5. Just as a side note, I think we've actually been saying his name wrong all this time.
Really?
I've been watching the game for the past few weeks, and every single commentator has been calling him Kessié, which
Kessié.
I'm not buying into. So I'm going to call him Kessié still.
Okay,
I don't believe in it. I'm not buying it. So Frank the Tank Kessié still gets a 5 from me. The international break, hopefully it's some kind of opportunity for him to have a rest, because I think there was, flashes of him at his best tonight, in terms of his being combative, being pressing forward. But I just feel he's not as effective as he was in the first few games of the season. And hopefully, I know he's got international duty to think about, but if there is an opportunity to have a rest, I think he'll do him some good, and hopefully he's recharged the batteries when we come back. But on this occasion, not a terrible performance, but just again, up to his standards, not as good. So I'm going to give him a 5.
yeah, I completely agree with you, mate. I've gone with a 5 as well. I thought, yeah, great. It showed great intensity at times, like you say, what we're used to from Frank the Tank. But then he just disappeared. It was like it just completely dropped off. So, like you say, I think I agree. He needs to definitely recharge those batteries, and hopefully, we do get the Kessié that we saw at the start of the season. But at the minute, he's literally dead on his feet. I don't think he can maintain the level of intensity for 90 minutes. And I think that's, again, I don't want to be too harsh on Kessié. I think Montella has to take a little bit of the blame for not managing him properly. But yeah, I think he showed his sparks of what he can do, but it's just not consistent for the whole match.
100%. Lucas Biglia, what are you giving him, Jace?
I've gone with a 5 again. I felt he surprisingly had a lot of time on the ball, but just didn't use it well. It was quite wasteful, I thought. And I think he was caught ball watching a little bit from when the Angadang burst through for the second goal. And I felt probably could have reacted to it a bit more. Position he's playing, that's his job, sniff out danger. And I think he's kind of jogging a little bit. And then when the Angadang picks up the ball, he's like, oh no, I need to go and get back, but it's a bit late by that point. So yeah, I felt he really was just a bit wasteful.
No, that's fair enough. I've actually given him a 6, but I take your points on board absolutely. I did enjoy watching his battle with Nangalan at times. I thought he offered decent defensive coverage in general, but taking into consideration what you said, yep, definitely dropped off on that occasion. His distribution was a little bit wayward, which was a little bit disappointing, like I said, but generally, I think it was okay. So I've kind of given him a little bit more of leeway and given him a 6. Çalhanoğlu, I've given a 5. He's really frustrating me, Jace, because I feel like he's got it in him to be a really creative and sort of driving force for us in midfield. And you can see it in really small bursts, whether it's like a real intricate little 1-2, whether it's just a driving run or just a picking out a pass. You can see he's got it in him. But at the moment, he's just struggling to put it all together, and he's just too sloppy, too indecisive, and off the mark, whether it's with his passing or shooting. Obviously, the sending off late on gets him marked down, and I think he's got a real task on his hands now to kind of repay the faith that Montella's shown in him, and to like prove that he deserves to be a regular starter, because Bonaventura is knocking on that door every week. So I've given him a 5, and I was really happy to see him in the starting lineup, but he just didn't deliver, so has to be a 5.
Yeah, I agree with your points. I've given him a 4 because of the sending off. I think it kind of, my eyes marks him down a little bit, because that definitely 100% killed the game for us. I think, 2-0 down at that point, 10 men, I think it's pretty much impossible for us to get back. But yeah, I agree. I think, he didn't really offer much. He doesn't seem like he's at it again. And I think he should have been taken off a lot earlier. I know we talked about this off air, but you could see he was struggling throughout the game. Montella should have been a bit more decisive. But yeah, I've gone with a four because, you know, now down to 10 men and he's going to miss the derby, which is a massive game for us.
Yeah.
But yeah, I was disappointed with Hakan today.
See, I've got a soft spot for him, giving him that five. Ricardo Rodriguez, Jace, what are you giving him?
I've gone with a six for Rodriguez. I thought he put in a decent effort, working hard, putting in crosses, but a little bit wayward with his crossing. I don't know if you can 100% blame him, or you know, maybe the two guys up top should have been doing a bit more to get on the end. But I think in those situations, you got to, as a professional footballer, you got to be a bit more intelligent, as opposed to just throwing it in to a box where no one's there. Do you know what I mean? I think he's definitely got the quality to do more with it than that. You know, hold up the ball, look for a teammate to feed possibly. And I just felt, you know, a game like this, I know he's trying to make things happen, but you're kind of just giving away possession if you're doing that. And I think it ultimately cost us up top. You know, we didn't really have a wealth of chances. I think when we get into those positions, he needs to be more intelligent with the ball.
Yeah, I'll pick up on that point in a second, because that was kind of something that was frustrating me during the game. But I've actually given him a seven, but again, I think I'm being generous. I think, you know, you see his technical quality on the ball, defensively solid, energetic to get up the left-hand side and swing those crosses in. But yes, I agree, no quality on those deliveries, because I don't think any of them actually found Kalinic or Silva. So probably being a bit generous, but I'm going to give him a seven. But just picking up on your point in terms of all those, you know, the endless amount of crosses from Barini's side as well.
Yeah.
Do you think that's down to the players, or do you think that's, again, a justification to criticise Montella? Because you've got Fazio and Manolas in the centre of Roma's defence who were absolutely loving balls being chucked into the box so they could head it out, being so, you know, dominant in the air themselves. We looked at our best and most threatening when we had it on the deck, playing it around and playing those intricate passes to each other. Is that tactical, or do you, like you mentioned there, is that down to the players to think, actually, do you know what, I shouldn't cross this ball in, let's swing it into the middle and kind of build something from there instead, and, you know, effectively, if you like, go against maybe what Montella's told them potentially?
Yeah, I think it's personally down to the players in that situation, because it's not as if, like you say, tactically Montella could have instructed them to do that, but we do have a player in Kalinic who, I know, like Roma, like you say, they have Manolas and Fazio in there, but Kalinic, the reason we've brought him in is for that option, you know, to be able to throw the ball into the box,
yeah,
and have him up there to challenge. Maybe if he's not getting shots on target, just getting flick-ons or putting pressure on defenders like Manolas and Fazio. So I think when it's not working, it, as a tactic, on paper, it should work. We should be getting at least some joy from putting balls into the box and getting Kalinic on the end of them. But if it's not working in the moment, I think it's up to Rodriguez and Barini, like you say, to then, you know, just be a bit more intelligent with it. You know, if you're not going to release it, maybe hold on to it, maybe try and draw a defender in, maybe take it to the byline and put it back. And,
yeah,
you know, once you're in the box, who knows, you're running that pace in the box, you get brought down, possibly you get a pen. Do you know what I mean? I think just once it's not working, because it clearly wasn't working, I think after a while, as an individual, you kind of have to say to yourself, okay, maybe I should try something different. This may not be what the manager wants, but I know I'm on the pitch, I'm constantly getting up and down, expending all this energy, getting up top and then just wasting it. If I was Rodriguez, I'd be annoyed the fact that I'm having to run up just to give the ball away. So I would have done something different, definitely. But I take your point. I think if it's not working, then maybe Montella should have changed it a little bit, maybe with the personnel, maybe taking Kalinic off and saying, you know, let's now play it on the deck. Let's get another, like we mentioned, Catrone. Let's get him up there and let's stop the crossing and let's try and get it to feet or get it in behind for Catrone to run onto.
Yeah, definitely. I think both are culpable on this occasion then. Kalinic, Jace, what are you giving him?
I've gone with a five for Kalinic. I think he had a chance, didn't he? Should have done better with a header. But again, similar to what we talked about, just not really getting on the end of the crosses. I think you see they're coming in. He needs to try harder, I think, to make a nuisance of himself in Roma's box. And he kind of went missing a little bit, in my opinion. I felt he could have done a lot more to support Silva, and I don't think, like we say with the crossing, I don't think he was using his best assets, as it were.
Yeah, I agree. I think, well, I've given him a 5 as well. I think he had moments in the build-up play, but ultimately it's just not enough. I think a bit more decisive in the final third. And again, I do come back to that point that he came up against a top defender in Manolas. But
yeah,
like I said, more of a nuisance, needs to do more for us. So disappointing for me, so I'll give him a 5. Andre Silva, to wrap things up, I'll give him a 7. A good performance. I think the only thing that was missing was a goal, to be quite honest. It's good to see him start. I did call for that after the midweek game, that hopefully, you know, Montella gets the message now and starts him in the league rather than this rotation. Did show flashes of some flair and excitement with his skill on the ball. And, you know, he looked dangerous, not only, you know, for himself, but he's creating for others as well. So I was really impressed with him. Thought it was a good outing for him personally. So I've given him a 7.
Yeah, I agree. I've gone with a 7. I thought definitely was the player that most likely to make something happen in that game. Like you say, his skill on the ball, his running. Good movement as well off the ball. Just, again, I agree with you, no end product there. Is that solely down to him, his fault? I think if he had a bit more support, may have been a different story. But yeah, I agree. He definitely looked dangerous. And he personally, like you say, he can hold his head fairly high with his performance today.
Definitely. We're going to skip the substitutes because, again, I don't feel they had enough time to make a decent, you know, impact on the game. But Cutrone and Bonaventura, fingers crossed they get opportunities moving forward. Something that we are going to bring back, which we forgot last week, Jace, was the man of the match and the flop of the match. Your man of the match for this one?
I'm going to go with Silva, I think.
Yep, agreed. Silva, as you mentioned, yeah. Exactly the same points we just said then. I think he was the most dangerous, the most likely man to make something happen. So he gets man of the match. And your flop of the match?
My flop of the match is Hakan, just simply getting sent off. I think in that situation as well, he was a little bit anonymous throughout the game, and then, you know, costing your teammates, not only in this match, but we talked about the big one next time out against Inter.
No arguments moving from me, my man. Hakan as well, full house. Yeah, agreed on those two. Twitter comments and questions. Samir Mohammed, from 70 minutes 0-0 to 90 minutes 2-0 down, how do we do it every time? I don't blame Montella for this loss. His man of the match was Barini, and flop of the match was sadly Hakan. Yeah. It is something that's, you know, cropped up. We saw it against Sampdoria. I think, you know, Lazio was a little bit different, capitulated on either side of half time, but, you know, he does make a valid point in terms of there's that little, you know, that little window in the last 20 minutes of games where we seem to just drop off and hurt, you know, the opposition hurt us. Can even go back to the Rijeka game. You know, we were 2-0 up, cruising. Then for some reason, yeah, we switch off and we've got ourselves a game. We have to bail ourselves out late on. So is that a mentality instilled in the team? Whereas Montella to blame, or is that the players switching off and they deserve the blame? What do you put that down to?
Yes, that's a difficult one, isn't it? I think you kind of have to look at the manager. If it's something that's reoccurring, like you say, it is. That's a good point. The Rijeka game, you forget because we got 3 points that we did have. It could have been a massive capitulation. But yeah, it is. I think you got to blame the manager in terms of what is the game plan when, you know, the score is, I say, if we're winning with 20 minutes to go, or if we're. You know, still trying to get a goal back or get our noses in front. Is there a game plan that he sits down with the players and says, you know, okay, we're going to step the intensity up, or this player is going to drop in here, this player is going to push up there? I think when you're in these situations and it's such a close game, as it were, when you go 1-0 down, I think, you know, you normally see instructions being passed on from the bench. I don't think Montella does that well, does he? In my opinion, I think 1-0 down, you have to kind of tighten the ship up. It has to be concentration. So what happened tonight doesn't happen again, that we go 2-0 down very quickly and then, you know, all of a sudden the game's gone. So I personally will blame Montella, I think.
Yeah, I mean, I find it hard to myself on this occasion, just purely for the fact that we did put ourselves in a position to win the game. We were decent for 70 minutes, and I feel like it was, like I said, the fight was there, the players responded, and I feel like we could have got the result was there for the taking. But yeah, I do feel like Montella and the players have to both take their share of the blame on this one. But hopefully it's not something that continues after the break, or we can eradicate this from our game. At MD Coop 3 said, Silver is class. Where's the real Bonucci? Team needs more pace, stagnant off the ball, no creativity. Did I miss anything? Drink away the anger. No, again, all points that we've both argued previously. Bonucci, bit better on this occasion, but still there are question marks there. Hakan Knutson said, Montella out, simply, with a hashtag. at McShegs also asked, can we sack Montella now? Where do you stand on it, Jace? Obviously, looking at the table, we're currently sitting in seventh. We're four points adrift of Lazio in fourth. Obviously, I'm not sure many people are looking at the top spot, but if you are, we are now, how many points is that? 9 points adrift of Napoli at the top. Is that enough for you to suggest Montella to go over this international break, or are you fully expecting him to be the man in charge when we come back for an Inter game?
I think, you know, the Ancelotti sacking has made his position a bit more vulnerable, but I think if there wasn't a manager of Ancelotti's quality available, and obviously the history he has with the club, I would fully expect Montella to be there. But at the minute, it's a little bit up in the air, because I personally, I know you asked me this question last pod, if it was up to me, I would sack Montella and get in Ancelotti, but that's only because I feel Ancelotti is a better manager and can probably do more with the team. But I think to take Montella's performance in isolation, I don't think he's done enough to deserve getting sacked. I just simply think that, you know, when you've got the opportunity to bring back a manager like Ancelotti, I think you have to take it.
You know, I've defended Montella a lot throughout this whole season, and those, you know, those shouts of Montella out are getting louder and louder every week. Doesn't sound like there's going to be a change. I think Mirabelli again came out after the game and said, nope, we're definitely behind Montella 100%. So there's no need to, in terms of, expect a change there. But how many times have we heard that vote of confidence, and then the next thing you know, they're gone. So it's certainly an interesting situation. But I personally think he'll still be around. I think if we lose the derby, and if we lose it badly, then I think game over. I think we'll all lose our patience and he's got to go. But for the time being, I think he's relatively safe. But I could be wrong. I have been before, so we'll have to wait and see.
Yeah.
Good stuff, Jace. Right, so that wraps up this weekend's podcast. Just for the listeners, we'll be with you during the international break. Don't worry. Tune in later this week as we talk in depth about Montella, comments from Fasone about his situation, and we rate the start of our season to date. So in the meantime, Jason, unless there's anything else you'd like to add, I think that's us for tonight.
Yeah, I think we covered it all.
Good man. So yeah, thanks for listening and subscribing. But until next time, Jason, nothing else but to say goodbye to the people.
Goodbye to the people.